We are continuing to track a tropical disturbance that is to the south of the island of Cuba here this weekend. You can see with the satellite imagery this disorganized collection of thunderstorms that's here again to the south of Cuba and to the east of the Yucatan Peninsula. And this is an area that is becoming a bit more concerning for the possibility of some tropical development. In fact, the National Hurricane Center has now pegged this feature with an 80% chance of developing into some kind of tropical cyclone, be it a depression, a tropical storm, or a hurricane, sometime in the next 5 days. So as this system continues to develop here, where can we expect it to go? It does appear here that throughout the rest of this weekend, this will develop into some sort of low pressure center just to the north of Cancun, and then through the early hours of Monday morning, track across the Gulf of Mexico. And it's at this point in its lifespan where it's forecast to be at its strongest point, either a tropical depression or a tropical storm. It does appear the center of this feature is going to try and favor areas to the north of Tampa up toward the Big Bend area of the state, move across northern Florida through early Tuesday morning, then pop out on the Atlantic Ocean and move up the coast of the South Carolina and North Carolina coastline as you progress through the day on Wednesday. So as this develops, everyone wants to know, of course, how strong is it going to be? It does seem very likely this could in fact become a named system, a tropical depression at least. Of course, tropical depressions are tropical storm systems with max sustained winds that are below 38 miles an hour. It's also a possibility this could be able to strengthen to tropical storm strength classification, in that, of course, it's packing winds between 39 and 73 miles an hour. If this system is able to become a tropical storm, it would likely be toward a sort of a weaker tropical storm feature, as it doesn't have a tremendous amount of space to strengthen once it makes it over top of the Gulf of Mexico. The prime concerns as this system organizes over the Gulf out of the Caribbean is the rainfall that it will bring to areas of South Florida especially. This is a view towards Sunday night. Notice how some very heavy rain developing north of Cuba over the Gulf of Mexico, and this will all continue to progress toward the east and northeast, of course, closer to the state of Florida. Now, it doesn't really matter where the center of circulation goes. Of course, that's forecast to be way up here toward the Big Bend area of the state. You'll notice though how the forecast models do paint in some fairly heavy rainfall occupying the west coast of Florida and notably over central and south Florida through the day on Monday and even in toward early Tuesday morning as well. And with all the things that are in play here, it seems very likely the west coast of Florida could see some pretty substantial rainfall over the next 4 to 5 days. This is a one particular forecast model's interpretation of some select points here, and it seems possible again some areas of the west coast of Florida could see more than 6 inches worth of rainfall by the time things are all said and done by toward early Wednesday morning as the system pops out on the other side of the state and over the Atlantic Ocean. So that is why Monday and Tuesday are so unsettled there. Conditions will turn a touch drier toward Wednesday and Thursday, staying warm across the board.